Hello, Lynn. What's new with you?
Hi, Nikki. I just learned about something called figurative language.
Figurative language? What's that?
Well, apparently you can use it to enhance your writing and make it more exciting to read.
Really? I would love to learn about it. Can you teach me?
Sure. One of the easiest types of figurative language to use are similes. Similes compare two different objects using the words like or as. For example, the bee buzzed around the flower like a jet coming in for a landing.
Oh, I see. How about this one? My friend is as sweet as candy.
Good job. Now a metaphor is a little different. A metaphor compares two different objects, but it does not use the words like or as. Here's an example of a metaphor. My thoughts are rabbits hopping around frantically in my head.
I like that one. How about this? Ants are soldiers, marching along in formation.
You're really good at this. Okay. Here's another type of figurative language. Idioms are groups of words that have a special meaning when they are used together. If you think about them literally, they make a funny picture in your head. Here's a couple of idioms. His teacher told him to hit the books. The dress costs an arm and a leg. It was a piece of cake.
Understand. So, you crack me up would be an idiom, because I'm not really cracking up. It actually means that you make me laugh. Right.
Exactly. We use idioms every day and don't even realize it.
This figurative language stuff is a lot of fun.
Yeah. I think so too. Similes, metaphors, and idioms are my favorite types because they can really improve your writing when you use them correctly. It's important to only use them when they fit nicely, and my teacher told me to be sure to not put too many of them in at a time.
I can see where too much of it would be distracting for a reader, but a little bit could help make your writing more descriptive.
That's it. Let's practice some more idioms, just for fun now that we're all on the same page.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say this is the best tip on writing I've gotten recently.
Now hold your horses. There's lots more to learn about writing.
Okay. I won't put all my eggs in one basket.
That's right, because Rome wasn't built in a day.
Well, I'm on pins and needles to learn more. Hey. This is a lot of fun. You all need to try this.
All of you keep practicing on your figurative language, and we'll do some more next time.